what surprises me is after reading this paper, I went on and had a further look at how many times rock, paper, scissors comes up in just papers that have been published in the last 20 or 30 years. There's an astonishing amount of literature on rock, paper, scissors. And I think, so one of the papers, the really famous paper, was where they found this rock, paper, scissors stuff in nature. So there's a certain type of lizards that use, the way that the males dominate one another follows a rock, paper, scissors type game. There's the orange lizards. These are the guys, they're called ultra dominant, right? They've got big territories, they've got loads of females. They're the big guys, right? Then there's the blue lizards. Their territory is much smaller. And you can tell the difference by the way that their throats are coloured. They're called side blotched lizards. So the blue lizards have much smaller territories and fewer females who they guard more carefully. And then the third type of lizard, yellow lizard, they're kind of roamers. They're called sneakers. So they don't have any territory or females of their own, but they can disguise themselves as a female and go in to attack one of the other territories. So the orange lizards, who have really big territories, lots of females, the sneakers, the yellow lizards, can come in and steal their females very easily. But the orange lizards can steal females from the blue lizards, who have a very small territory. Obviously, the big territory is really attractive to the female lizards. So that's kind of, the orange loses to yellow but beats blue. Then the blue lizards, who lose to orange, the yellow lizard has no way of attacking their females because they're really closely guarded. And actually a yellow lizard will turn into a blue lizard given half the chance. So the blue lizard traditionally with this very small loyal group of females does really well. So in that's kind of the way that the sort of cyclic dominance happens, and it ends up being, exactly the same mathematically to a game of rock, paper, scissors. So they don't have the sort of the human psychology, shall we say, of choosing to play strategies repeatedly. But because there's this population, what ends up happening, you can draw a little diagram, a triangle diagram like we had for rock, paper, scissors. Blue gets beaten by orange, orange gets beaten by yellow, and yellow gets beaten by blue. Now you can think of this as the populations of the lizards. So let's say if you're up here, this is sort of like an axis, each of these is like an axis. So if you're up here, the full population is blue, they're all blue lizards. If you're down here, they're all orange, and so on. So if you can imagine, if you start off with a high population of blue lizards, there then becomes an advantage for the orange lizards, right? So the population will kind of end up moving in this direction. And then if you have more orange lizards, it becomes an advantage for yellow lizards because they can beat them and so on. And you end up with these trajectories that sort of end up spiraling round. Now it depends on the exact situation as to whether they form closed loops or they spiral in or they spiral outwards. But this is kind of the dynamics that you have in the population of lizards. And it's exactly the same as the traditional rock, paper, scissors game. You'd play scissors.
Do you play rock, paper, scissors much?
Not really, probably not since I was about 10.
Should we have one go?
Yeah, go on then.
Ready? On three, yeah. Ready? One, two.